friends in high place.
His friends at his side.
Need to speak to the Duchess urgently.
All right, you scamps. Store is done. Go find your parents.
But the Pomeran. What about the story of Rittik and the dragon?
That tale's for another time. But take a good look at the man who stands before you now. This is Geralt of Rivia, the master witcher who lent his valiant hand to the defeat of the giant Goliath.
Master witcher, is it true virtue always trumps villainy?
Not always. Could go either way. Sometimes virtue wins, sometimes villainy gets the upper hand. Still worth being good.
But why? If it doesn't, mean you'll win.
Pomeran's story. Think back. A decent man attracts other good folk, makes friends he can count on. A rogue? Well, he can only count on other rogues. And who would you rather have for a friend?
A man of virtue?
I must agree. Now, that will do for questions. Go find your parents. Her Enlightened Highness has doubtless arrived at the tourney grounds to watch the battle in the arena. If we hurry, we'll be in time to speak with her before the spectacle begins.
Lead the way. Who's fighting? Nilfgaardian gladiators?
Close, but not quite. As you will soon see.
Someone's gonna fight a Shalemar? With only some bells on its tail to confuse it, slow it down?
Whatever is the problem? The beast is a gift, from the Emperor, no less.
Shouldn't torment the beast. How would you like to be dumped in an arena, blindfolded with a string of bells dangling from your ass?
Pity a monster. You, a witcher?
I slay monsters who are a threat to humans. You're out to humiliate one to entertain a crowd. No knight will gain any glory from this. Let's go.
I dedicate my imminent victory to fair Lady Vivian.
It's begun. The fight shall have to end first. We must wait.
The fate of the beast has been weighed by the gods. Soon the Witcher shall triumph against all odds.
Honor!
Out, out, brief flame! And thus the Witcher's life was stuffed. All our hopes, alas, had turned to dust. The Witcher waited till the time was true, then twirled, danced, and spun, struck the monster right through. Drink up the ocean and set fire to the wood. Nothing in this struggle can come to any good. Defeated by Geralt of Rivia, master of the witchering trade. Behold, as the last gasps of life seep from the beast.
Master Geralt, do what you must. Finish the deed!
It suffered enough.
The monster lies slain! The fight is done! Praised be the victors!
Guillaume?
The lad came damned close to dying.
I'm fine. Not hurt at all. Vivian?
Smile as befits a hero and keep silent. Speech clearly paints you. She approaches.
Geralt, we must talk. Vivian.
You shall talk later, in the medic's tent.
Geralt, magnificent, breathtaking.
Your grace.
We knew that to summon you was a brilliant idea. We are delighted, raffish, to have struck upon it.
And I'm truly, honored.
See to our young hero. Hop, hop, for we must make off with Geralt. We should talk. We had been long awaiting your arrival, had nearly lost hope. Then suddenly, that entrance, so spectacular.
Your Grace, my contract. I'd like to discuss it.
Naturally, but not here. We shall need Damien. He led the investigation pending your arrival. But wherever could he be? Come, we must find him.
Tell us, have you come alone? Or did Viscount Julian accompany you?
Wish to see Dandelion, Your Grace?
Yes. I mean, no. Yes. But solely to tell him we regret. Yes, deeply regret rescinding the death sentence we so justly handed down upon him. If we could turn back time, we would make certain he sat in a tower till he rotted. No, we would ensure he was broken on the wheel, then drawn, hanged, and quartered. Ah, the very man we would entrust with these tasks. Damien de la Tour, captain of my personal guard.
Your Grace, Witcher.
Greetings. Sorry to have to tell you, but the guardsman handling the last victim's body...
I know already. The creature in the cellar of Corvo Bianco. Was it the beast?
No. A Bruxa, a kind of vampire. Not the beast, but tied to it in some way.
You know this how?
Through careful analysis of the evidence, both on the riverbank and at Corvo Bianco.
Do you mean to insinuate the investigation thus far has been sloppy?
Geralt insinuates nothing of the sort. We must listen to him attentively.
I examined the body of the beast's last victim. Might have found something. Need to analyze it. A quiet place, that's what I could use most right now. And maybe the help of an alchemist or a mage. Also like to hear all you know about the previous victims. Take it Sir Delatour is my man for that.
Firstly, call me Damien, please. Secondly, you should know I spoke against summoning you here. I've heard much about you. You bring trouble, or thus far have, always. And we've enough trouble as it is. Yet we are capable of defeating the beast on our own, without an outsider's help. I've no doubt about it.
Damien, we settled the matter of the Witcher's employ some time past. Definitively. Since you have broached it nonetheless, let us discuss Geralt's pay. Are the legends true? Do Witchers usually demand that which you find at home, yet did not expect?
Not quite, Your Grace. Law of surprise? It's something we invoke at times, but rarely. Usually we just take gold.
Disappointing. This law sounds rather romantic. On the other hand, on returning to the palace, we would likely find impatient petitioners or a set of sample fabrics for a new dress. Poor rewards, both. I fear you'd not have much use for any of the surprises we are likely to come upon. Thus, we've decided you shall receive the deed to a vineyard, Corvo Bianco, and a sum of coin. You will doubtless consider this adequate. Title to the vineyard shall be given to you at once. Surely you'll need lodgings while you hunt. The coin, however, will be yours only once you have slain the beast.
Lovely, generous gesture, Your Grace. But, Corvo Bianco, isn't it the Duchy's temporary morgue?
Is it now? The Chancellery's bungled things again, we fear. Not to be left unsupervised for one instant. Yet, in its mood, a morgue should present minimal problems to a Witcher. What's more, nothing enhances a wine's reputation better than a grim legend.
Thank you, Your Grace. I accept the contract, of course. But as I said before, I'll need some information. How'd it start? Who was the first victim?
Crespi was the first to die. He was famed once for his many glorious tournament victories. Then he grew old, hung up his sword, and took to winemaking.
Crespi was not loved by the wine merchants. He was ruthless in business and thought to cheat many a time. He asked us for a dispensation from all court ceremonies. We did not grant it. We could not. Once you've taken the oath of a knight, you remain a knight till death.
How'd he die? Where'd they find the body?
Quite unusual, the circumstance. He was at a feast when suddenly one of his fellow feastgoers noticed he was missing. The town watch found him an hour later. On his hands and knees, propped against the town pillory, his sword hanging from his neck. He had died of wounds inflicted with claws, not a weapon. Blows of great force.
So he died suddenly, but the body was on its knees, meaning someone posed it.
So it seems.
Second murder. Tell me what you know.
In the city, there are certain nooks. No one reasonable ventures there after dark. Ramon Dulac's corpse was found in one such place. With the first murder, terror gripped the city. Its inhabitants grew wary, kept to safe areas. Consequently, news of the second victim came to us from a group of concerned
cut purses.
Criminals fear the beast? Telling in a way. Take it you've excluded the possibility that Ramon died at the hands of these bandits.
Do you believe me, an amateur? Not hands, but claws killed Ramon Dunac. The wound was deep, clean.
His body was found in the gutter, dressed in nightshirt and cap, a pillow placed under his head, and his sword replaced by a bed warmer. Ramon Dunac, a knight who but a dozen years past was an advisor to our father, the Duke.
Someone went to a lot of trouble to make him look ridiculous. Maybe revenge was the motive.
It's not out of the question. Dunac had shady dealings with the criminal underworld, but no one ever came forth with concrete proof of any misdoings.
So, first two victims were knights, best years behind them.
The same could be said of the third. Sir Delacroix was wont to claim that in modern times, knights face new challenges, enterprise being the latest addition to the chivalric virtues.
He made a veritable fortune in the grain trade. Palmerin even nicknamed him Sir de la Stinchy.
Found a coin pouch on his body. Contained florins dating from various times, hailing from different provinces of the Empire.
Delacroix loved coin, true, but had no patience for numismatics.
Lots of similarities between the victims. All the bodies were found in strange places, under extraordinary circumstances. Seems the murderer, whoever or whatever it is, has some meaning to convey.
These were honorable men. We are horrified by the disdain, the disrespect with which they were treated. These were knights of Toussaint. Blast it.
Might be the point. From what you say, none was a model of virtue. Ever considered that's what the beast's trying to draw attention to?
All the murdered men were knights who swore fealty to the five chivalric virtues. And even if the...
Knights of Toussaint swear fealty to what virtues, exactly?
Honor, wisdom, generosity, valor and compassion.
Beast seems to be pointing up moral decay, denouncing it. Victims were all humiliated. Might have been murdered to emphasize their lack of specific chivalric virtues.
Honor, compromised by the pillory. Wisdom, by ridicule. Generosity, by a coin pouch shoved down a throat. It seems to fit, true, though not perfectly.
Can't discount the theory if it's on the lips of everyone in town. Say our reasoning's right. Next murder will be just as showy and denounce the victim's lack of the fourth virtue, valor. We can also assume that victim will be an elder knight.
Let's think. At the moment, all the knights are either at the tourney grounds or in the palace gardens. Our annual hare hunt shall begin there shortly. Have you heard of the custom?
Milton mentioned something. Seemed excited to prance around in a bunny costume. Not sure why. Hang on. Strange circumstances. A knight advanced in years. The famed cowardice of rabbits.
Could it be that simple? Is Milton de Peyrac Peyren the next victim?
Milton also knew Delacroix. Told me so down by the river.
Damien! To me, something so obvious. De Peyrac Peyren, Crespi, Delacroix, and Delac formed a knightly team. It was years ago, but...
Your Grace, we need to find Milton. Immediately.
Rather problematic. You see, the garden entertainments are due to start, and he's disguised as the hare, hiding somewhere, waiting for some tipsy courtiers to find him. The hare's hiding place is a carefully guarded secret.
We must call off the game, at once.
First and foremost, we must remain calm. Damien, order the garden searched, immediately, but discreetly. By no means can we disrupt the festivities. Panic will only incite the beast to strike sooner. And you, Witcher, follow me. My gardens, my knight, I shall take the fall. A murder is out of the question. I will not allow it. Not near my palace. Horses! Ready our horses! Your Grace!
Thank you. What the hell? Why, I should... Your Highness, I...
Mind it doesn't get wrinkled.
Onward! Hey! That is silk! Be careful! Give it to me!
Grace seems right at home in the saddle.
Clear the path! Clear the way, I said! It's here! Just round the corner!
Hurry!
We must go to where the game is being held. The participants must find a unicorn's horn, a golden fish, and a phoenix egg. With these in hand, they can deduce where the hare, Milton, hides.
Maybe we need to find those things too.
We've no other option, but time is of the essence, so we shall have to break the rules.
Death's a fish, no.
On second thought, through here. I shall show you where the hunt plays out. Then we will split up. You will get hold of the unicorn horn and the golden fish. While I nab the phoenix egg. That will be quickest.
Golden fish. Do I need a rod or a net?
Please, Geralt. It's not a real fish. Look there, towards the water. See the lights? The hunters are trying to hook the fish from boats. You must simply dive in and find it.
The unicorn. How do I catch it?
It's terribly skittish, true, but I'm sure you will find a way to earn its trust. It runs around, over there, look. The golden fish and the horn both contain things or clues that will help us find Milton. Once you have fish and horn, find me among the other phoenix egg hunters. All clear? Then let's get to it.